Then the Dutchman Roland Scholten. This is the furthest he's ever got in this tournament. Ronnie Baxter, finalist here in 1998. Can he reach the final this time around? He's with Helen.
Well, Ronnie, here we are again. Congratulations on your win last night. You didn't miss very much. You were sharp on those doubles.
Yeah, in the earlier, of course. Yeah, that's why I was 12-3 up. But giving him five legs back-to-back, and if he'd have set off like he played them five legs, I'd have given him all them chances. And me missing them doubles, I could have been in trouble. But he set off really badly, and I just put it on as I normally do.
How's your confidence at this stage of the tournament?
Pretty good, it always is here. It's my hometown, in a sense, it's my birthplace, and I've always done well here. I've had the odd upsets, but mostly of all, I've been very good here.
Because you last got to the final in 1998, I believe, you met Rod Harrington in the final. So you know what it takes to go the distance in this tournament, don't you?
Well, yeah, I do. I mean, I got Phil on the way there in the last eight. It's my first tournament as well. And everyone was just saying, well, he's not going to do anything. And that was especially Rod. But I nearly taught him a lesson in that final, but it never happened.
OK, well, best of luck this afternoon, Ronnie.
OK, thank you.
Ronnie Baxter ready to make his way onto the stage against Roland Scholten. Will it be as exciting as that first match we saw? James Wade in awesome form. The winner will play Wade in the semi-final of the competition. They're ready. Hope you're ready at home. Don't forget Taylor Priestley, Mardle Hamilton, still to come in the evening session. But this, the conclusion of the afternoon, the second quarter-final of the Stan James World Match Play. Our MC is Phil Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you now please welcome on stage for our second quarter-final here at the Winter Gardens Theatre. The world-ranked number 11 from Holland, the Flying Dutchman, Roland Scholten!
Business head on, hasn't he, Roland Scholten? So too Ronnie Baxter. Could go the distance, this one. Rod Harrington, John Gwynn in commentary. I guess you two, it's just sinking in what you've seen with that phenomenal performance from James Wade.
Well, the fact is, Dave, there's no 23-year-old rising star on the stage, two very experienced performers. But thanks for the opportunity for Rod and I to say to James Wade, well played, son. A wonderful, wonderful performance. He's having a tremendous week. And I know that this man, Roland Scholten, 41 years of age, from Den Haag, Holland, knows it's a hard act to follow, but his mind is fully focused on Ronnie Baxter, Rod, but wonderful James Wade, that, and he's had three wonderful matches here, but that was very special, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think he's come of age this week. I think we're going to see a different player when he plays from now on. And there's Ronnie Baxter's stats there, he's from Swindon. He beat Dennis Smith, and Smith is here today, and he's well and looking good. And then against Mark Walsh last night, going 12-3 up, and then giving Walsh a load of legs, which was uncharacteristic of the Rocket.
Yeah, I think he admitted afterwards that he took his foot off the pedal. The game was well and truly won, and he found out, almost to his cost, that it wasn't quite. You've got to wait until you hit that winning double.
Ladies and gentlemen,
so,
first leg,
we're going to sit back and hope to see a game that measures that one we've just seen. And you have to say, hard luck, Chris Mason. You just met a man who is in supreme form at the moment. As I say, 86 years of experience on the stage here. And the Rocket Ronnie Baxter flew off the pad yesterday and took 100. Off into space very rapidly indeed with 6-7 legs in a row. Was almost caught in the end, but made it. In fact, this man shot victory over Andy Smith, 10-6 in the opening 55. Round, and then Andy Jenkins, 13-8 in the second. Ronnie Baxter beat Dennis Smith, 10-4 in the first round, and as we know, Mark Walsh yesterday evening. So soon 96. On stage again after that match last night, Rob.
Yeah, I think Ronnie, if he could have won that game 14-3 last night and got away from the venue an hour earlier, it might have made a little bit of difference. But to be quite honest, John, 100. When the adrenaline starts pumping, and it really starts pumping about a half an hour before you walk on that stage, there's no tiredness, there's nothing. All you can feel through going through your body is the will to win and the want to win. These two players, it's going to be a very fast game, and I think it's going to be a game of missed doubles, and the person who can jump on that.
Yes, it's best of 31, rather longer than the Premier League matches they've been playing, of course, in the earlier part of the year. Strangers to each other. I would say that pretty well even Stevens. Two of the players, Rod, only five players now of the top 16 are left 100. In the tournament, obviously five of eight anyway, or seven as it is now. So that's not bad, really, as he's looking at ball for double 16.
49.
Yeah, John, I think that's the way the game's going now. You know, we see in most tournaments, there's a lot of the seeds going out in the first and second round, and that just shows the quality and depth that the PDC have got now.
That's a lovely dart. It should leave him nicely on double eight, yes. But Baxter, double top. Had one or two problems with it yesterday. Hit it a couple of times, but he so often...
Ronnie Baxter!